Hi, this is Vaibhav, your EJ, that is your Edu Jockey. With this video, we'll be starting with the conics. And our first topic will be parabola. In conics, basically, there are three curves of our interest. The first is parabola, next comes the hyperbola, and then the ellipse. We'll be concentrating only on parabola in this video. Let us take a line. Let this line be Lx plus My plus n equals to 0, and let us take a fixed point S whose coordinates are suppose a and b. So one thing that we should know is this line is called as directrix and this point is known as focus. Now we take any arbitrary point P whose coordinates are h comma k. What we're gonna exactly do is we're gonna give some conditions connecting the directrix, the point P and S such that we get the locus of point P. So let us draw a line from point P onto the directrix, which is perpendicular directrix. Also, let's join point P and S. Let's label these points. Let this be M. So in conics, the first relation that we have is PS by PM is a constant, and this constant is denoted by E. And this E is known as eccentricity of the curve. Now writing PS and PM, you know that PS is equals to H minus A whole square plus K minus B whole square under root. And PM is, this we have obtained by using the distance formula. Again, by using the distance formula for distance between a point and line, we get PM as LH plus KM plus N by root of L square plus M square. Now substituting the values of PS and PM in this relation will give us root of H minus A whole square plus K minus B whole square is equals to E times LH plus KM plus N by root of L square plus M square. Squaring both sides we get. Now coming to the next condition of conics, if E is greater than 1, then what we get is hyperbola. If E is equals to 1, then what we get is parabola. And if E is less than 1, then it is ellipse. One more thing that is important is the general equation of conic is ax square plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus 2hxy plus c equals to 0. If you want to see this eccentricity stuff in this form, then on solving what we get is if then a square is greater than ab. Here a square will come out to be equals to ab, and here h square will come out to be less than a. Don't confuse this h and ab with the h and ab used out here. These are entirely different. These h and ab are the one used out here. Now let's come to the parabola. In general, we always deal with standard parabola. So let's see what standard parabola is. So this is our standard parabola. This axis is x-axis and this is y-axis. This is a point S which we call as focus in our general equation of conics. So this will be our focus out here as well. This line, as you must have guessed, is our directrix, and this is a parabola whose equation is y square equals to 4ax. Now let's see what the coordinates of these things are. The equation of the directrix is x equals to minus a, and so we can see that this point must be minus a comma 0. The coordinates of focus are a comma 0. Here this point a is known as vertex of the parabola. So we can see that y-axis is a tangent at the vertex, in x-axis is passing through vertex, and here x-axis is the axis of the parabola. Now let's understand each term of standard parabola one by one. So let me draw a small figure for you. So first term is focus. So let's focus on the focus. Focus is a, 0. The focus is represented by S. In this diagram, let me represent focus for you. The focus is out here S, a, 0. The next term that comes is axis of the parabola. Here our x-axis is the axis of the parabola. It is a line which passes through vertex and is perpendicular to the tangent at vertex. Axis is also our line of symmetry. Let me show you how. This is a parabola. Now this line is cutting the parabola into two halves, and it is acting as a mirror for the two parts. We can see that the image of lower part is the upper part, and vice versa, the image of the upper part is the lower part. Hence, axis is also our line of symmetry. Third comes the vertex. Vertex is the point of intersection of parabola with the axis. Here, vertex is a, 0, 0. The fourth term is double ordinate. Double ordinate is any chord perpendicular to the axis. So let me show you. Suppose I draw this chord. It's perpendicular to the axis. It is a double ordinate. I draw a chord out here. Again, it is a double ordinate because it is perpendicular. So these two are our double ordinates. Fifth comes the focal chord. Focal chord is any chord passing through the focus. So let me give you an example. This is a focal chord. This is also a focal chord. Focal chord is just like any chord. The only thing is it passes through focus. Hence it is given special importance. We'll see later the use of focal chord. The sixth point of interest is focal radii. It is denoted by PS. You must have remembered that point P denoted any general point on the curve when it comes to conics. It is a line segment joining any general point on the parabola to the focus. It's any general point P, and it's the line segment which joins any general point to the focus. One more thing worth noting is that PS is equals to PM. Let me draw PM for you. As we draw earlier, this is PM. This is because of the property, as we already said, that PS by PM is E, and here in case of parabola E is 1, so which gives us PS is equals to PM. The seventh thing is latus rectum. It is a double ordinate passing through focus. Here you see double ordinate. It is a chord perpendicular to axis, and it's a special case of double ordinate that it is a double ordinate which passes through focus. Focus is focus e, 0. In other words, we can also say it is a focal chord which is perpendicular to the axis. The length of latus rectum is 4a. We'll see how it comes later on. One more thing that is sometimes used is semilatus rectum. Semilatus rectum is nothing, just the half of latus rectum, as is clear from the name. So its length will be 2a. Now with understanding of these terms, let's go ahead. One thing to be noted is, now you must really be wondering what are parabolas of use to us. So let me tell you about some common examples of parabola which we come across when we study. The first quite interesting example is the projectile motion. Now let's see what projectile motion is. It is a 2D motion of an object under constant gravitational field. So it is like you standing out here and you have a stone in your hand. You throw it. And let this represent the path of stone that you're throwing. So this path is what always acting on the stone. So the motion of the stone is somewhat like parabola. Why I say somewhat like? is because there is air resistance acting on this. If we neglect the air resistance, then it is parabola. Now let this be the highest point where the stone has reached. This is what we call as the vertex, and this is the direction of gravity g. The one thing that is found is that the direction of the constant acceleration, that is g out here, is parallel to the direction of the axis of the parabola. So this is gonna represent the axis of our parabola. The next place where we come across it is quadratic equations. You must have all seen the quadratic equation of the form y is equals to ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not zero. This is y, x-axis, y-axis, and what the curve is looks like is somewhat like this. The other time may be like this, and yet another time may be like this. These are a few times what a quadratic equation looks like, and all these curves are parabolas. It is just an equation not written in standard form, but yes, it is still a parabola. Well, let's come back to our original figure. Here, one more thing that you can note is the directrix. This yellow colored line is a directrix. The equation of directrix is x equals to minus a. And the thing is, distance between the directrix and the focus is semi-latus rectum, that is equals to 2a. It's very easy to prove. This is x equals to minus a, that is the distance of a from the tangent at the vertex. So this distance is a. Again, distance as is also a. So a and a give us 2a. So distance between the focus and the directrix is semi-latus rectum, which is 2a. Now this was a standard parabola. Now what you're gonna do if you get some any random parabola, that is whose axis is not x-axis and whose tangent at vertex is not y-axis. The best example is what you would have done in this quadratic equation. Yeah, it's clear that it's not a standard parabola, but still we know that it's parabola. So let's take any random parabola. Now this is the axis of a random parabola, and this is tangent at the vertex of the random parabola. Let the axis be some line ax plus by plus c equals to 0. So we can say that the tangent at the vertex will have the line of the form bx minus ay plus d equals to 0. Let me make it very clear that this is not any random line. The b and a used out here are same as the b and a used out here. This is because these two lines are perpendicular to each other. So the product of this slope should be minus 1. We can check out here is that is it happening actually? The slope of this is minus a by b, and the slope of next one is minus b by minus a, and yes, it is equals to minus 1. So these two lines are perpendicular to each other. Yeah, I agree that d is any random variable out here. Now how are you gonna solve the problems related to these things? So what you just have to do is you have to assume this as your x-axis represented by capital X, this as your new y-axis represented by capital Y, and put x as bx minus ay plus d by root of a square plus b square, and y as ax plus by plus c by root of a square plus b square. An interesting concept related to parabola and any conic is that you take a point h comma k out here. Its distance from this line, that is a fake x-axis, assumed x-axis, let it be represented by d axis, its square is equals to 4 A, that is twice times of semi-latest rectum, R equals to the latest rectum, the distance from tangent at vertex, that is from this line. To verify this, let's come back to a standard parabola. If we see what is the distance from the axis represents, it is just the y coordinate. So here, writing it as y square, and the 4a is as it is, and the distance from the tangent at the vertex in our standard parabola, the tangent at the vertex is nothing but the x-axis. So here we can write x, and we get our standard parabola. So this is the stuff which is worth remembering.